Hey there, I'm Max.
And I'm Turbo.
What's wrong, Turbo?
Nothing, I just give up.
Give up? On what?
This, that, everything.
Come on, Turbo, no way. This is what you were made to do. You were just telling me the other day how much you love being a part of Good Love's racing team. You do love it, don't you?
I love it more than anything. It's just, sometimes it's hard work. Always greasy, always waiting for the next race. I think maybe it's time to hang up my hat and be done.
Turbo, when you love something or someone, you never give up. I know you love what you do, and because I love you, I am not willing to let you give up.
You aren't?
No way. In fact, let me show you something. I think you will totally get where I'm coming from. Check it out. Once there was a woman named Naomi. She lived in a town called Moab and was happily married with two sons. Sadly, one day, her husband died. She was so upset, but she still had her boys and their wives, Orpah and Ruth, to keep her company. Well, about 10 years later, more bad news came her way. Both of her sons died. Naomi decided it was time to go back to her hometown of Bethlehem. So she told Orpah and Ruth her plan and that it was best for them to go back to their families. They'd be better off that way. When Orpah and Ruth heard what Naomi had said, they cried and cried, begging Naomi to take them with her. Orpah didn't want to leave Naomi, but Naomi told her not to worry, she would be just fine. So Orpah left to go back to her family. Ruth was a different story. No matter what Naomi said to Ruth, she would not leave. She told Naomi, "Wherever you go, I will go, and wherever you stay, I will stay. Your friends will be my friends, and your God will be my God." Ruth loved Naomi and wasn't willing to give up on her. So Ruth and Naomi took the trip all the way to Bethlehem together. Once they got there, it wasn't all sunshine and roses. No way! They had to figure out how to live and how to eat. That's when Ruth came up with a plan. It was harvest time, so she decided she would work in the fields gathering grain. Ruth would provide food for her and Naomi by following behind people who were picking barley, and if any dropped to the ground, she would grab it up. Ruth worked all day long in the hot sun, picking up what grain she could and barely took a break. She loved Naomi and wanted to take care of her, so no matter what, she never gave up. One day while she was working, the owner of the field, named Boaz, stopped by to say hello to everyone. And that's when he noticed Ruth. He asked one of the workers, "Who is that girl?" And they told him how she had come all the way from Moab with her mother-in-law, Naomi, and how she had loved Naomi so much that she would never give up caring for her. Well, Boaz noticed all of Ruth's hard work, so he gave her lunch while she was working and even extra grain to take home to Naomi. Ruth was surprised that he had noticed her, but was so thankful to Boaz for his help. This story has such a great ending because eventually Boaz fell in love with Ruth and pretty soon they were married.
I think I see what you're getting at, Max.
Let's race through that again.
Naomi's husband and her two sons died.
Orpah went home to live with her family, but Ruth stayed with Naomi.
They left Moab and went to Bethlehem.
They needed to find a way to eat.
Ruth went to work in the fields.
She never gave up and worked long days picking up grain left behind.
Boaz noticed Ruth and took care of her.
Ruth and Naomi had enough to eat.
Boaz and Ruth ended up getting married and lived happily ever after.
See, Turbo, because Ruth loved Naomi, she didn't give up on helping her. And I'm not about to give up on you. You're one of the best in the pit crew here on Good Love's Racing Team. And no matter how hard things get, you've got to know you can't give up.
You know what, Max? You're right. We have one more race to go, the big one. Let's get our tails in gear and make this happen.
Now you're talking. That's the Turbo I know and love. Let's go.